Good morning, students. So let's start the class, today's class, with the discussion of the homework which I gave in the previous class. So the question that was given as homework was 690 minus 336. So can I do 0 minus 6? No, because 0 is small and 6 is big. So what should I do? I need to take borrow. So I'll take from 9 and I'll make it 1 less, so it becomes 8. And here this becomes 10. What is 10 minus 6? It is 4. And 8 minus 3 is 5. 6 minus, if there is nothing, then you have to consider it as 0. 6 minus 6 is, 6 minus 0 is 6. Alright. Now, let's go on to the next question. Today, we are going to do the same subtraction with borrow, or as we say, subtraction with regrouping. The only difference between today and yesterday's class is, here also there is a 3-digit number. And here also there is a 3-digit number. This is the only difference. Okay. In the previous case, if you see, I taught you all 3-digit minus 2-digit numbers. Today we are going to do 3-digit minus 3-digit numbers. Alright. So the same question is there in today's worksheet in the no notes also. Okay. So look at this video carefully. Then you will be able to do the questions in the notes. What is 4 minus 4? 4 minus 4 is 0. 5 minus 9 is what? Can we do 5 minus 9? No. We need to take borrow. 4. So we'll take from 4. 4 will become 3. Okay. And with this 5, I'm going to write 1. What is 15 minus 9? 6. And what is 3 minus 2? 1. So the answer is 1, 6, 0. Okay. Let's look at the next question for today. Can I do 0 minus 1 here? No. So what should I do? I need to take borrow. I'll take from this 1. What comes before 1? 0. And here what should I do? Add 1. What is 10 minus 1? 9. Can I do 0 minus 6? No. I need to take borrow again. What will this 9 become? 8. What will this 0 become? 1. 10 minus 6 is 4. 8 minus 8 is 0. Clear, children? Let's go to the next question. 4 minus 9. Can I do 4 minus 9? No. What should I do then? I need to take borrow. Let me take borrow here. 1 will become 0. And 4, here I'll write 14. So what is 14 minus 9? Yes, 14 minus 9 is what? It is 5. Can I do 0 minus 3? 0 is small, 3 is big. Can I do? No. So what will I do? I'll take borrow again. 5 will become 4 and 0 will become, this will become 10. What is 10 minus 3? 7. What is 4 minus 2? 2. Is this clear? This is the second question in the class notes that are given. See the next question now. 2 minus 5. Can I do 2 minus 5? No. So what should I do? I'll take borrow. Take borrow from 3. 3 will become 2. And this will become 12. Okay, this is given to you as homework. So I am just going to explain you here. You are going to do the calculation yourself. Can I do 2 minus 8? No. Why? Because 2 is small and 8 is big. So what should I do then? I have to take borrow from 6. So 6 will become 5 and this will become 12. This I am not going to write the answer. You are going to do it yourself. I will just show you today's notes. So the same questions were explained to you in the PowerPoint. Okay. And these are the three questions that are to be done in the class notebook. It is the same exercise. Exercise 4.2 part 1 only. But it is question number F, G and H. Okay. And I have given question number E as homework. This question we will discuss in the next class. Okay. So this is your work for, and already I discussed in the last class, homework was also discussed with you. Okay, in the beginning of the class I discussed, right? Remember? Okay, so do these questions. This is one question I gave as homework. Okay, once I complete the recording of this video, I will upload the video link here as well. Thank you, students.